Joe emerged like a giant termite to chew up the flag to a deadly white. Our blood was evil because it was red, and we ourselves is blue, so we had to be took out too. The problem was the rise of democracy. Fighting fascism in the Second World War exposed the American dream as white supremacy. Imperialist ventriloquists raised the Red Scare to cover a democracy that had never been there. So our red allies in World War II were demonized by funky media before the bourgeoisie was through. Some whack politicians, stooging for the dead, attacked all who opposed them, accused them of being red. Finally, people began to see the strings in Joe's wooden head and peeped the puppet master by where the strings led. Joe was in the Capitol representing Capitol, crouching at his master's feet, who pulled his strings directly from Wall Street. Meanwhile, the Hollywood 10 went to jail for making flicks would make you sick. Dashiell Hammett, the thin man searching for the Maltese Falcon, was jailed because he was a private eye, not a public lie. Our friends Hutton, Dr. Du Bois' man, got jumped when they busted the doctor at Robeson for refusing to deny that America was poison. The movies ain't been much after that. And things like Kazan got great careers and Larry Parks got paid to be Al Jolson. They got people fired, got snitches hired, made punks out of erstwhile intellectuals, made haughty academics quiet and ineffectual, Robeson under house arrest. Richard Wright turned right, Langston got shaky, Reagan became an FBI former, lobotomy for Francis Farmer, Zero Mostel caught hell, he wouldn't tell, Lee J. Cobb kneeled, Sterling Hayden squealed, Jackie Robinson stole home by putting down Robeson. Kennedy Lee was blackballed. He was already black. It became a crime to think they called the Smith Act so they could send the Communist Party leadership to jail. And skunks, and fools, and betrayers, and naysayers, and whores, and rituals, and red channels, and hiss dismissed. Insanity passed for vanity. And knives were plunged into backs all across the land. When the final ugliness of this purge of democracy, from the fake democracy, plummeted to its lowest there, they framed the Rosenbergs and had them murdered in the electric chair. While the Bilbos and Innocents and Thurmans and Stenisons and Clans and Quiggles and hideous fat appetites passing for human beings burped and farted, and grinned and rested easy in their greasy. At the time, lynching and beating and robbing and cheating, and character assassinating us, and the poor and working people in truth, and the country settled back and thought to an oatmeal constipation. A bald-head, half-grinned toy soldier who whispered military industrial complex just before he died to try to get to heaven. But as punishment, his son married Nixon's daughter. So God knew he lied. But that was not real. This tense, gobbledygook puddle of America spelled mediocrity. The man in the gray flannel suit tonight had been secretly feeling on other women. But the reflection on insurrection, the invisible man from 1954 was ultraviolet. Began to appear viewed under certain instruments. The ultraviolence of Mississippi called money, which is made by slaughtering niggas for rapping, for raping Miss America with their words, their eyes, their ideas, their needs, their existence. Emmett Till smashed, head of Jet magazine. The undigested nigga hope answered with bullets and rope, a 13-year-old boy. Miss America's uncle chose to destroy. And we saw in that colored magazine that the cracker was evil and obscene. And we declared war somewhere in our places of enemies as sweetness and cool. The barbarian vandals who had sworn to make our lives always and forever their commode for. Whose laughter was always a beacon of terror. whose fatness or wealth or cribs or rides or decrees or east had always been scars on our consciousness, whose haughty insincerity, even while being kind, was nothing but a minstrel show. If only we would kill, but we would not. Too advanced in life to be murderers. Otherwise, we would be murderers, even to themselves. But we hung, we watch, our eyes swing, our hands sometimes tremble. We stumble, we throw the hook shot, slide in the second, touch each other and laugh, pray inside ourselves that we will not have to take these maniacs' lives.